SmartSuite has some of the best permissions for users inside of the no-code space. In this video, we're going to be doing a deep dive on these permissions so that you can better assess how to share access with your SmartSuite solutions across your teams. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. SmartSuite is one of our favorite tools heading into the new year, and I am excited to speak about it here, specifically because we're going to be doing a deep dive on the permissions inside of SmartSuite, which are best in class. They get really, really granular, and we can change and alter how people interact with our SmartSuite solutions thanks to these permissions. But before I jump into that, I want to quickly invite you to use our affiliate link, which I will include below this video. Grab that link and get started with SmartSuite today. It's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel and say thanks for these videos. But also, if you upgrade to a paid plan with SmartSuite, they send exclusive swag to our viewers who use that specific affiliate link. So if you're thinking about going all in with SmartSuite, definitely check that link below and make sure that you've signed up through there so that you can get your SmartSuite swag. All right, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen and you can follow along with your own solutions as well inside of SmartSuite. Now, the first place that we want to talk about permissions is at the solution level. So let's quickly rewind and go back to our homepage in SmartSuite. So here we have a number of different solutions. And as the workspace admin, I see pretty much everything in this space. So you can see that we've got quite a few different things already working here. But I've favorited a few and they're up at the top of my list. And so if I wanted to alter permissions, I can do that really for any of these. Now, of course, that requires that you have the right level of permissions inside of that solution. So if you're the workspace admin or the creator of a particular solution, then you should have the capability to adjust who can access that. So here I'm going to use my hourly consulting solution as an example as we walk through. So here we are inside the solution and we see that it has four different applications. The first place that we start thinking about permissions is at the solution level. So here it is at the hourly consulting level for this example. By clicking up on the solution and coming on down about three or four icons down there, we have the permissions option. You'll notice that right now I already have some permissions granted to this particular solution. And if I mouse over to the little information tag here, we also get the pop-up on the side that talks about how to manage solutions. So if you're ever stuck, this is one of those great parts on SmartSuite where they've put together some incredible help docs that are very interactive with the tool itself. But let's go ahead and close that down and we're going to just drill into the permissions right here. Now here we see that we have access granted at a few different options. So we have all members. So this is just a default blanket where we say, boom, all members have full blown access to this particular solution, the end. So this is the easiest way to do it. As you add a new member to your SmartSuite workspace, they'll automatically get access to this solution. But we can go deeper. Next option down, which we currently have selected here, is that only specific teams have full access. So this is where the team element inside of SmartSuite really comes into play. When you add a new user to SmartSuite, you can assign them a team. Let's in fact back out of here and I'll show you exactly where to go for that. I'm going to access my profile here and go down to Workspace Administration. Then we have the third tab over called Manage Teams. So here you can see that we have created three teams for our particular workspace. And these teams are comprised of members. And so we have multiple members per team. So I could add a new team here. Let's call it the hourly consulting team. Just go ahead and type that in right here. And then we can decide if this is a public type, which is the only option available right now, and whether this particular team is active or not. Now I can add people onto the team. So here on the left, I have an option for all the different folks on my team, and I can choose who's a part of this specific team, who belongs to the hourly consulting team and who does not. So I can just simply make that selection and then create the team. Now we can always, at any point in time, come back here and recreate this team, or rather add new members, edit the team, change the way it's constructed, move it to inactive. We can always come back here as workspace administrators, go back to manage teams, and then edit whatever we just created. So here's that new team that I just created. And if I want to take this now to the next level, I simply go back to my workspace, back where I was before, inside of the solution permissions, and here's where I can now access that team. So I can add this team right to the solution. Now, the benefit of doing this is that if in the future I add new people to our workspace, and when I bring them into the space, I add them to that new team, well, then they're gonna instantly get access to this solution as well. And the reason that this is such a huge time saver is because when I onboard a new person, I don't wanna have to manually give them permission to a dozen different solutions. Well, now all I have to do is add them to the appropriate teams, and if I've properly assigned my teams to my solutions, they're gonna automatically get access to all of the solutions that pertain to the teams that they're on. So it's that simple. I really love this feature, being able to add people to teams and grant permission to teams to access certain things. Let's go a layer deeper though. Our last option here at the solution level is to grant advanced permissions. So we can reference a team here and just bring in a team, or we can bring in individual members and give them whatever type of access we want to give them. So you'll notice that in SmartSuite, we have a bunch of different types of users. A user can be a viewer, and a viewer can view all content but cannot create, edit, or comment on the content. So it's read only, they can't really interact with it, but they can see it. Then we can move to commenter, a step above viewer. A commenter can view and comment on all content, but they cannot create or edit content. So they can see it and they can comment on it, but they can't do anything to it other than have a conversation. Then we have the assignee permission. Assignees can view and edit content that they have been assigned, but cannot create, view, or edit any other content. So this is a really cool type of permission that we haven't seen in a lot of other tools. And this allows us to say, hey, look, let's go ahead and bring somebody in as an assignee and allow them to edit all of the data that pertains to them, but they don't see anything else. So if it's not their data, they're not going to get access to it. Then we have contributor. Contributors can create content and edit content. They have been assigned and they can view all other content. So they can only create and edit content that they've been assigned to, and otherwise they can view everything else. A step above that, we have editor. We have the editors who can create and edit their own content but only view other content. And then of course we have full access. These folks can create and edit all content. So a lot of different layers of permissions here that are way more advanced than most of the other tools that we experience in no code. So as you can see, six different options here, getting progressively more powerful as we go up the ladder. So we can get as granular as we want here. We could say, hey, this particular team, they have assignee permissions. And this team over here, they have editor permissions. And maybe I want to override that. And within that team, I'll bring out Colette and say, hey, Colette, I know you're a member of maybe the hourly consulting team who has contributor access, but I want you to specifically have full access. So then you can get even more granular by bringing out certain people and adding them just like this. So you'll see that it breaks down here. Again, we're looking at the solution level, but we have a breakdown by team and then by members as well. And do note that whoever has the highest access of permission, that is what's going to be granted. So if you're assigned to a team and you have a higher level of permissions on that team than you do as an individual member assigned to you, you'll always get the highest level of permission that's been assigned to your account. So that's at the solution level, but now let's go even deeper, because SmartSuite permissions don't only allow us to configure things at the solution, but also at the application level. So I might say, for example, that I want everybody to have access to this particular solution, but I don't want them to be able to see the consultant's application. So maybe I want to lock down this application and hide it from view. Well, in order to do that, I can then click on the application itself, drill into permissions yet again, and you'll notice that by default, an application will inherit its permissions from the solution, meaning that, well, this is what the permission level is at the solution level. So by default, we're going to have that same blanket response to permissions across the entire solution, including all of the different applications. But I can override that. I can override the solution permissions here and say, hey, actually, I want to rein that back or dial it up, right? So maybe I might say, you know, Colette has access, again, we'll pick on Colette, to this total solution, but I don't necessarily want her to be able to do everything here in this particular space. So I want to lock her down and only give her viewer access, for example. So it's possible for me to come in here and remove or grant permissions on an individual or on a team basis. Notice that I can still access those teams. So I could go all the way down and start accessing teams here again. And just remember that the advantage to using teams is as soon as I add new members to the team, the permissions carry through for any new members added. So again, we can drill down now, not only at the solution level, but also at the specific application level, override the solution permissions for that application, go ahead and save any changes, and then we're good to go here. Now, that's not all, because SmartSuite, within a few weeks of this video coming out, will be including the ability to remove the permissions at a field level. So inside of the application, I can allow people to see my total application. Here I have my consultants, but maybe I don't want my consultants to know everybody else's rate, because that's some information I might want to keep confidential. Well, pretty soon, I will be able to drill in here and close down permissions at the field level. So I could say, hey, I want somebody to see everything here, but I don't want you to know the rate. So let's go in, close down the permissions for all users except for management, for example, at the rate level, so that we're not sharing private confidential information. So this is going to be an incredibly game-changing new feature, which again will be coming out in early 2023. I'm really looking forward to it, just having the flexibility of these permissions taken even more granularly down to the field level. It's going to be game changing. I know we went fast and covered a lot in this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to drop them below. And if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to the channel to stay up on no code news just like this. That's it for this one. I will see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found this to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website to see how we can help. We offer an exclusive free training that teaches the fundamentals of no-code tools, including automation. We also have some paid services available, including advanced courses, no-code hourly consulting, as well as custom project consulting. So swing on by to get the help you need, and we look forward to connecting with you soon.